In this lecture, we will have the discussion on the demodulation process of the DSB SC modulated signal. If you take a quick look at the block diagram of the communication system, in the transmitter section, we have applied the DSB SC modulation technique and have modulated the message signal by shifting its maximum frequency FM to a higher frequency or a lower frequency by using the carrier frequency plus minus FC. After performing the modulation, the signal is transmitted from the transmitter to the receiver through the channel. The receiver receives the modulated signal, and this modulated signal needs to be demodulated to get the actual information or the message signal. At the receiver end, the message signal is recovered from the received DSB SC signal, and the process of extracting an original message signal from the DSB SC modulated signal is known as detection or the demodulation of the DSB SC modulated signal. The following modulators or detectors can be used for the demodulation of the DSB SC modulated signal, and they are coherent or synchronous detector and Costa's loop receiver. Let's see how the DSB SC demodulation is performed by using coherent detector or synchronous detector. Let us see the block diagram of the synchronous detector. First, you will see the block diagram for the synchronous detector. In the block diagram, at first, the received DSB SC modulated signal is given as the input to the product modulator. A carrier signal generated by the local oscillator is another input to the product modulator. In this procedure, the locally generated carrier is exactly coherent or in synchronism in both frequency and phase with the original carrier signal CT that is used to generate the DSB SC modulated signal. Output of this product modulator is YT, and it is given as the input to the low-pass filter with the cutoff frequency FM. The output of the low-pass filter is our desired demodulated message signal or Y0T. As the carrier signal generated by the local oscillator is needed to be synchronized in both frequency and phase with the carrier signal used in DSB SC modulation, that's why this demodulation technique is known as coherent or synchronous detection. The whole block combined with the balanced modulator and the low-pass filter is known as synchronous detector. Let's see the mathematical analysis for this synchronous demodulation technique. The mathematical analysis can be done by applying three methods. In the first method, we will consider that the carrier signal from the local oscillator has a phase shift phi and an amplitude of 1. In the second method, we will consider the carrier signal from the local oscillator having a phase shift of 0 degree and an amplitude of 1. In the final method, the carrier signal from the local oscillator has a phase shift del f and an amplitude of 1. Let us consider the first case. In this case, the carrier signal from the local oscillator has a phase shift phi and an amplitude of 1. Let's say modulating signal or message signal mt is equal to am cos omega mt, and the carrier signal CT is equal to AC cos omega CT. So the DSB SC modulated signal ST is equal to MT into CT. According to this case, the carrier signal from the local oscillator has a phase shift phi and an amplitude of 1. So the carrier signal from the local oscillator can be given by C prime T is equal to cos omega CT plus the phase shift phi. The output of the product modulator can be given by V1T is equal to ST into C prime T. If we replace the value of ST as MT into CT, then V1T is equal to MT into CT into C prime T. Now, let's replace CT as AC cos omega CT and C prime T as cos omega CT plus phi. Then V1T is equal to MT into AC cos omega CT into cos omega CT plus phi. Now, we can separate MT and AC from the equation, and V1T will look like V1T is equal to MT into AC into cos omega CT plus phi into cos omega CT. This omega C can be replaced as 2 pi FC. So V1T is equal to MT into AC into cos 2 pi FCT plus phi into cos 2 pi FCT. Now we need to divide and multiply this equation by 2. V1T is equal to MT into AC divided by 2 into 2 into cos 2 pi FCT plus phi into cos 2 pi FCT. Now we know that 2 cos A cos B is equal to cos A minus B plus cos A plus B. So if we apply this formula in the following equation, then the equation of V1T will look like V1T is equal to MT into AC divided by 2 into cos 2 pi FCT plus phi plus 2 pi FCT plus cos 2 pi FCT plus phi minus 2 pi FCT, which can be simplified as V1T is equal to MT into AC divided by 2 into cos 4 pi FCT plus phi plus cos phi. Now we need to multiply MT into AC divided by 2 with both the terms, then V1T will look like V1T is equal to MT into AC divided by 2 into cos 4 pi FCT plus phi plus MT into AC divided by 2 into cos phi. This equation shows that the output of the product modulator YT consists of two terms, where first term is equal to MT into AC divided by 2 into cos 4 pi FCT plus phi, and the second term is equal to MT into AC divided by 2 into cos phi. The first term is the message signal multiplied with an amplitude of AC into cos 4 pi FCT plus phi, which means that a new DSB SC signal with a carrier frequency equal to 2 FC, and the second term represents the message signal MT with an amplitude of AC cos phi. And this term is our desired term, and the first term is undesired. Now, this can be shown in the frequency domain as this illustrates the spectrum of the product modulator output V1T of the coherent detector. Amplitude at this point of the frequency spectrum, where frequency f is equal to 0, is equal to half into AC into M0 into cos phi. And at this point, half into AC into M0, and V1T is equal to half into MT into AC prime into AC into cos 4 pi FCT plus phi, half into MT into AC prime into AC, plus half into MT into AC prime into AC into cos phi, where AC prime is the amplitude of the carrier signal generated by the local oscillator and AC prime is equal to 1. Now we will pass this signal through a low pass filter. The cutoff frequency of this low pass filter FC will be greater than omega but less than 2 FC minus omega. Now to get the desired output signal, YT is passed through a low pass filter which only allows the low frequency term or the second term to pass through and will reject the first term. Here it is assumed that in the frequency of the message signal is limited to minus omega to plus omega. So when we take a low pass filter with a cutoff frequency greater than omega but less than 2 FC minus omega, it will only pass the second term and reject the first term. Therefore, the filter output is given by V1 naught t is equal to MT into AC divided by 2 cos phi, which can be reorganized as V1 naught t is equal to AC into cos phi divided by 2 into MT. Here phi is the phase error and the demodulated output is proportional to the message signal MT. If the phase error phi is constant, depending upon this value of phase error, the output will be minimum or maximum. The output will be minimum when phase error phi is equal to plus minus 90 degree and the output V1 naught t is equal to AC into cos 90 degree divided by 2 into MT or V1 naught t is equal to 0. This effect where the output of the coherent detector is 0 is known as quadrature null effect. This quadrature term represents the phase difference of 90 degree as cos omega ct plus phi becomes cos omega ct plus 90 degree, which is equal to minus sin omega ct, which attenuates the demodulator output by making the output equal to 0. As long as phase error is constant, the detector provides an undistorted message signal MT. In practice, however, we find that the phase error phi varies randomly with the time due to the random variation in the communication channel. The result is that at the detector's output, multiplying factor cos phi could also vary randomly with the time, which is obviously undesirable. Therefore, provision must be made in the system to maintain the local oscillator in the receiver in synchronism in both frequency and phase with the carrier wave to generate the DSB SC modulated signal in the transmitter. The resulting system complexity is the price that must be paid for suppressing the carrier signal to save the transmitted power. Now, in the second case, the carrier signal from the local oscillator has a phase shift of 0 degree and an amplitude of 1. Like previous, the DSB SC modulated signal ST is equal to MT into CT, where a modulating signal or message signal MT is equal to AM cos omega MT, which is equal to AM cos 2 pi FMT. And the carrier signal CT is equal to AC cos omega CT, which is equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT. Now, the carrier signal from the local oscillator has a phase shift of 0 degree and an amplitude of 1. So the carrier signal from the local oscillator C prime T can be given by cos omega CT. The output of the product modulator V2T is equal to ST into C prime T. If we replace the value of ST as MT into CT, then V2T is equal to MT into CT into C prime T. Now the CT can be replaced as AC cos omega CT and C prime T as cos omega CT, and V2T can be reorganized as V2T is equal to MT into AC into cos square omega CT. Now we need to divide and multiply the equation of V2T by 2, then V2T is equal to MT into AC divided by 2 into 2 into cos square omega CT. We know that 2 cos square A is equal to 1 plus cos 2A. If we apply this formula in the following equation, then V2T will look like V2T is equal to MT into AC divided by 2 into 1 plus cos 4 pi FCT. Now we need to multiply MT into AC divided by 2 with both the terms of V2T, and V2T will look like V2T is equal to MT into AC divided by 2 into cos 4 pi FCT plus MT into AC divided by 2. This equation shows that the output of the product modulator YTS consists of two terms, where first term is equal to MT into AC divided by 2 cos 4 pi FCT, and the second term is equal to MT into AC divided by 2. Here, the first term is the message signal multiplied with an amplitude of AC into cos 4 pi FCT divided by 2, and second term is also a message signal multiplied with an amplitude of AC divided by 2. This is our desired term, and the first term is undesired. Just like the first case, if we pass V2T through a low pass filter, which will allow only the low frequency term to pass, or in this case, the second term will pass through and will reject the first term. Therefore, the filter output can be given by V2T is equal to MT into AC divided by 2, and V2T can be reorganized as AC divided by 2 into MT. Now, in the final case, the carrier signal from the local oscillator has a phase shift of del F and an amplitude of 1. Like the previous, the DSB SC modulated signal ST is equal to MT into CT, where now the carrier signal from the local oscillator has a phase shift of del F and an amplitude of 1. So the carrier signal from the local oscillator can be given by C'T is equal to cos into 2 pi FC plus del F into T. Now the output of the product modulator can be given by V3T is equal to ST into C'T. If we replace the value of ST as MT into CT, then V3T is equal to MT into CT into C'T. Now CT can be replaced as AC cos 2 pi FCT, and C'T can be replaced as cos 2 pi into FC plus del F into T. If we replace 2 pi FC as omega C, then V3T can be written as V3T is equal to MT into AC cos omega CT into cos omega C plus del F into T. Now we need to separate MT and AC from the equation, then V3T is equal to MT into AC cos omega C into T into cos omega C plus del F into T. Now we need to divide and multiply the equation of V3T by 2, then V3T is equal to MT into AC divided by 2 into 2 into cos omega C T into cos omega C plus del omega into T. Now we know that 2 cos A cos B is equal to cos A minus B plus cos A plus B. If we apply the formula in the following equation of V3T, then V3T is equal to MT into AC divided by 2 into cos 2 omega CT plus 2 omega C plus del omega into T plus cos del omega into T. Now we need to multiply MT into AC divided by 2 with both the terms, then V3T is equal to MT into AC divided by 2 into cos 2 omega C plus del omega into T plus MT into AC divided by 2 into cos del omega into T. The output of the product modulator of V3T is consists of two terms, where the first term is equal to MT into AC divided by 2 into cos 2 omega C plus del omega into T, and the second term is equal to MT into AC divided by 2 into cos del omega into T. Here, the first term is the message signal multiplied with an amplitude of AC divided by 2 cos 2 omega C plus del omega into T, and the second term is also represents the message signal MT with an amplitude of AC divided by 2 cos del omega into T. Here, first term is undesired, although the second term is shifted by the frequency del F, but when it is passed through the low pass filter, del F is very small. As the del F is very small, it will be passed through the low pass filter. So when the V3T is passed through the low pass filter, the second term will pass through and will reject the first term. Therefore, the output is given by V3T is equal to MT into AC divided by 2 into cos del omega into T, which can be reorganized as V3T is equal to AC divided by 2 cos del omega into T into MT. Here, cos del omega into T and MT is in the multiplication form. Cos del omega into T is an oscillating signal, and as it is multiplied with the message signal MT, it will change the amplitude of the message signal MT. So this recovered signal is a distorted message signal, and this is known as beat effect. So in this case also, we cannot recover the message signal properly. So both the case of frequency shift and phase shift, we are having some effect on the modulating signal and message signal. And in both of the case, we cannot recover our original message signal properly. So in order to recover the message signal properly, the carrier signal from the local oscillator must be synchronized with the carrier signal used in the DSB SC modulated signal. This concludes our discussion for this lecture. In the event that you have any question regarding this presentation, feel free to post them in the comment section, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.